proceedings are closed.
Swarms of United States aircraft fly in formation overhead as the ceremony ends. The final United Nations victory has been won. The war is over. Peace is here.
President Truman, recalling General Douglas MacArthur from his command, sets off one of the most dramatic and controversial news stories of the generation. In Tokyo, thousands of Japanese flock to the Daiichi building, the Supreme Allied Headquarters, to see the 71-year-old five-star general as he enters his headquarters for the last time. The next morning, a plane from Korea brings to Tokyo the new Supreme Commander, General Matthew Ridgway, named by Truman to replace MacArthur. The changes in command keep Tokyo's Haneda Airport busy. Lieutenant General James A. Van Fleet arrives from Washington en route to Korea to succeed Ridgway as commander of the 8th Army. Now the recalled Supreme Commander arrives at the airport for his trip home. After a farewell ride past a quarter of a million cheering Japanese. General and Mrs. MacArthur say goodbye to American and Japanese friends.
Well, since my baby left me, well, I've found a new place to dwell. For it's dark at the end of lonely street at Heartbreak Hotel. Heartbreak is a lonely baby, cause I'm so lonely. Heartbreak is so lonely, I could die.
It's only 100 years since the Japanese admitted foreigners to their country. And though we know much of their way of life, their philosophy remains almost a closed book. We know they wear white at funerals, black at weddings, and recently invented electric trousers. But to the Western peoples, they are the inscrutable Orientals, who failed to conquer the world by military means and who are succeeding through commerce.
On the brutal face of communism. And across the world in Japan, America's stronghold in the Pacific, the busy commies were at it again. Students went on a rampage in Tokyo with something less than successful results when opposed by Japanese police aided by occupation military police.